Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In this set of videos, you'll experience the Connected Conform workflow with enhanced usability through the Flame 2018.2 update. The Connected Conform workflow allows you to share the same sources and VFX across multiple timelines. So if you're working in any production that has multiple versions or cutdowns of an edit, you can make changes anywhere and all your sequences will remain in sync. The 2018.2 update now allows you to add more edits to the Connected Conform, even at different stages of production. It would be nice to receive everything at once, but realistically, you get your first edit, and more sequences get added as time moves on. So you'll be learning how to handle the situation. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast of this video, then type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. You need to set up a new 1080p 10-bit project and set the frame rate to 23.976 frames per second to avoid unnecessary time warps. So let's say that your regular working week starts on Monday. You're starting a new online job, and you've been supplied with the first 20-second edit and all the production media. Switch to the Conform view and call up the contextual menu to load a new AAF. In the file browser, navigate to the downloaded media. Go into the AAF directory and look at the contents for Monday. So this is the first edit you've received, and more sequences will get added as the week goes on. Select the 20-second AAF and disable any of the search and link functionality. Since you're going to use the Connected Conform workflow, you'll link to the media after a few extra steps. Import the AAF and Flame assembles the sequence without looking for any media. All the segments in the edit are classified as unlinked or missing media. The first step in creating a Connected Conform is to create a common sequence that contains all the media to be used across multiple sequences. Click the Create Sequence pull-down menu and choose Create Sources Sequence. The Sources sequence takes all the sources and spreads them out on a single video track. Traditional editors would call this a C-mode sort, where all your sources are spread out and exposed on a single track. This has multiple uses, including publishing all the source media for external grading. However, its main purpose in Flame is to collect all the media used across multiple sequences in this production. To find the media, you need to define a search location. This can be in or out of the Flame products. Since this project is empty, click the Search Location button. In the browser, navigate to the Media folder and click Set. Now there are a variety of ways to match your media up with your edit, and you do this by setting your match criteria. For the purposes of this example, you are using the tape name and source timecode to find a match. Close the Match Criteria window if it's open. The tick indicates that a match has been found for the event list entries. Before you link the media to the sequence, ensure Save Sources is enabled. This ensures the media is saved as separate clips in the sources reel. This is not a necessity, but it can be useful when browsing source media via the media panel. Secondly, you might have very long rushes and you don't need all the media to do the conform. So limit the handles and give the segments an extra 5 frames breathing room on either side of each segment. Now you're going to link the media to the sources sequence, therefore ensure the sources sequence is the main focus in the conform view. Click Link Sources. Now you might get this pop-up window, and this tells you that there will be multiple clips with the same name. This can happen when you have very long source media and you're only using small sections of that media spread across the file. So by limiting the handles, Flame is only bringing in what it needs. Therefore, you land up with multiple clips like this. Apply the settings to all choices and click Add. This will not add more to the actual sequences, but at least you'll know all the clips are in the sources reel. When you scrub the sources sequence, all the clips will be there, but spread out over a single track. To see the correct edit, switch over to the 20-second sequence. So this is the assembled 20-second version of the edit, and everything including the track layering should line up. Now let's say at this very moment, you've just been told to stop this job and help on another for the rest of today. So we'll fast forward to Tuesday morning, where you pick up this job again. Before you start, you are informed that the 15-second version of the edit is now available. So let's go ahead and combine the 15-second version into the Connected Conform. Carrying on in the Conform view, call up the contextual menu over the events lists and load a new AAF. In the file browser, navigate to the AAFs and go into the Tuesday folder. Select the 15-second AAF and import the sequence. By default, Flame opens the sequences in the timeline area, and as you can see, it doesn't link to anything at all. Now the sources sequence, as well as the 20-second sequence, are aware and linked to the media. In order to make the 15-second version of the edit aware of the Connected Conform and the media, you need to update the sources sequence to consider the 15-second version. Switch to the sources sequence. Click the Create Sequence pull-down menu and choose to update the sources sequence. When you do this, the sources sequence updates and adds any new media into itself to accommodate the 15-second and 20-second version of the edit. Some media may be re-imported, as well as recached if you have that enabled. You will also see markers in the sequence. If you open the effects bar to the right of the interface, when you select any of the markers, you will see that the name of the marker is Update Sequence, and the comment informs you why the segment was updated. Most of these segments have been extended to bring in the extra media for the 15-second edit. So by adding an additional edit to the Connected Conform, you update the sources sequence, and all the media for both edits will be contained within. So switching between the 15-second and 20-second version of the edit, all the media should line up in both, and the source media is shared between the two edits via the updated sources sequence. Now you're not only limited to updating the sources sequence at the beginning of the production. You could be receiving new versions in the middle of doing VFX work. So in part 2 of the Connected Conform workflow, you'll start working on VFX, and then you will be given another version of the edit to add to the Connected Conform. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.